Good evening, everyone. I'm Riley King, and welcome to my evening news report right here on the Riley King Network. Let's begin. Today on Good Morning America, Ryan Seacrest was on talking about Mariah Carey's planned return to New Year's Eve and also about the Rockin' Eve special he is hosting on ABC on New Year's Eve and also the return of American Idol. Let's take a listen to the first video on Ryan Seacrest's reaction to Mariah Carey's planned return.
The best unlimited in the galaxy. See Star Wars, The Last Jedi, now playing.
Now the guy who gets my vote for the coolest guy in entertainment, Mr. New Year's Eve himself, Ryan Seacrest, who will be hosting Dick Clark's New Year's Rocket Eve with Ryan Seacrest, 2018.
The coldest guy.
The coldest guy in show business. You said you're getting tips from everybody about how to stay warm out there.
Tell me what to do to stay warm. I haven't been in this kind of temperature before myself for that long.
You're going to feel it. We cannot wait to see the tricks you have up your sleeve for the big show. But Mariah Carey's coming back.
Yes.
There was a little uncertainty because of what happened last year.
It didn't go as planned.
It did not go as planned last year. You must be so excited, though, to have her back.
Listen, I've known her a long time. She's an old friend of ours, new year, about new beginnings, and she's a legendary, iconic artist, so we're excited to have her back to do it again. She's going to do a couple of songs, one of which will be Hero, right before midnight outside in that cold.
That's going to be hard to sing, those high notes.
Was this her idea to come back after last year?
I'm confused as to whose idea it truly was, but it's a good idea.
Just take credit for it.
It's not my idea, but it's a good idea. I think people are excited to see her back. People love her. She's beloved.
Yeah. You put out an all call to your followers on social media when it is appropriate time to take down your Christmas tree.
Right.
And she responded, and she said, "Darling, not until July 4th.
Darling.
Are you going to keep it up until July 4th?
That's probably too long for me. I like to keep it up at least to the first week of January, but Mariah, she is the queen of Christmas music and festivities and things like that, so I wouldn't doubt that she keeps it up till July 4th.
Dan's making fun of me. Well, not really. It's okay that I'm still listening to Christmas music, right?
You're asking me for my permission?
Yes, okay, right?
Do we have your permission?
As long as you don't do it around me, it's totally fine.
By the way, to take my tree down, I need help, Dan. Could you help me take it down? Because at my height, I can't get to the tree.
I think we're the same height.
So I can stand on your shoulders.
Absolutely.
I sense a love fest going on between these two.
At least a cooperation pact.
Exactly.
Ryan, thank you very much. We're going to be talking to you throughout the morning. So much to talk about with the biggest party of the year. A million people here in Times Square.
Okay, and there you go on that video. We want to hear from you. Let us know what you think. Is it a good idea for Mariah Carey returning to the Rockin' Eve stage and singing again this year? We want to hear your reactions. Let us know and comment below. And also, Ryan Seacrest dishes on New Year's Eve and American Idol. Let's take a listen to this video that happened on Good Morning America today.
Away from the big Rockin' Eve bash right here in Times Square. And who better to get the party started than Mr. New Year's Eve himself? Give it up, people, for Ryan Seacrest. Seacrest sick.
Well, I hope you feel better.
Thank you. We've been shaking our hands all week, though. Well, I mean,
come on.
Need I say more?
Marciano has been up.
Yeah, break it down.
What's he going to experience?
I was out there for 90 minutes and my mouth is frozen. I can't feel my toes. I don't know how you're going to do it. It's going to be 10 degrees colder than what it was. And you're out there for 5 hours?
Five and a half hours.
Here, take these.
What are these?
Body warmers.
I need tips.
Peel and stick them out.
These are frozen
California.
Well, they'll work with
and
those.
And you're coming out here to New York.
Well, yes. you said that you put an all call out there because it's going to be, what'd you say, the coldest temperatures I've ever heard in the last 50 years.
It could be minus. Look at the look on your face right now.
Well, it's terrifying.
Yeah. You put an all call asking people to, you've been soliciting some help. What can you do to stay warm? We have some ideas for you.
Oh, great.
We want to present with you a gift basket, an assortment of items to keep you warm.
Okay, here we go.
Coming in. Oh, here it is. It's a gift basket.
Yes.
Okay, tell me.
Well, these are warm. Wait, these are warm.
These seem perfect for roaming the streets of Times Square.
Yes. We got you a bunch of warmers. Just hold this in your
good.
Hands.
Okay.
Another slipper.
Suppose you like it.
Just one.
Yeah, this is fashion forward.
It's a poncho.
Yeah. Leaning way forward.
What is this? Is this just a large blanket?
It's either a blanket or a big cape.
Is there something in
here? I'm going to grandmother's house, apparently.
Yes, Little Red Riding Hood. And you must take the basket as well.
Okay.
And somehow we'll drop the ball with all of this.
Well, let's talk about the show, speaking of dropping the ball.
Yeah. Oh, and this mug, too. It's not a mug.
Yes, he saw the mug.
Right. Got it.
Which I think is
three quarters the size I am.
You know, Ryan, I have to say, you are, the thing I love about you is you are the Casey Kasem and the Dick Clark of our generation.
That's
really, you are. You absolutely are. For somebody who's been participating in this event for 12 years, what is your favorite moment?
Well, there's so many great moments. There's so many unexpected moments, one of which was last year when Mariah was on stage and she's coming back to do it again. But for me, every year that Dick Clark did the show with me, I'd come in, he would be inside, I'd come in about 12:20 a.m. and he would look me in the eye and say something, sometimes make fun of me, sometimes wish colder weather upon me, other times give me a hug. Well, Dick, I think you're getting your wish.
Yes, he's looking
this year
down from heaven.
Arctic weather.
No kidding.
I'm trying to think of what the coldest year was since you've been hosting. I know 2008 was cold, but nowhere near was.
Nothing like this. I've had it pretty easy. And, you know, I've lived in Southern California for so many years. I'm now in New York full time. So I'm getting used to it. And Kelly Ripa would always say to me, it was warm, wasn't it, Rob? Like seasonably, unseasonably warm.
Last year was 44 degrees.
But even this year was warm up until all of a sudden it dropped like
that.
Yeah,
it's balmy.
And she would always say it changes overnight. And it does.
I don't know if you ever get used to it, though. I mean, I grew up in the Midwest in the cold, and now I'm out here. I don't know if you...
I came home from Christmas and we were away for a week or so, and I got back and the heat was broken in the house. And so for the first night we slept with no heat. It's one of the things you don't think about when you live in Southern California is checking to see if your climate control is working.
Yeah.
But now I've learned my lesson the hard way.
Welcome to New York City. Let's talk more about the show. Any surprises? Anything that will be different this year?
Well,
besides the Red Riding Cape that he's going to wear.
Yes. Besides my trip to Nana's. I think with this show, it truly is the largest event that I'm a part of that's televised because of the scale, the size, the different performances, the ball dropping. You know, last year we had an unexpected moment with Mariah. She's come back. We're so excited about that.
That's awesome.
It's going to be an amazing moment with her. We've got Nick Jonas, Camila Cabello, Jenna McCarthy's co-hosting in Times Square, Ciara's in Los Angeles. We've got Imagine Dragons live in New Orleans. Lucy Hale will be hosting that. Britney Spears will be in Las Vegas for us. So we're bouncing all over the place with a big show.
And you're also preparing for the return of another hosting gig, American Idol. How excited are you? March 11th?
Sounds good to me.
Yes. You have, with a man who has like 17 jobs.
I haven't looked past midnight on New Year's Eve. But it is so exciting that show is so special to me, and I talk to a lot of people around the country that, you know, they grew up watching the show, they were born, watched it, and waited to be old enough to participate in the auditions, and when it went away, they were so bummed they couldn't, but now it's back and they can. So many great stories like that, so we're excited to relaunch.
Doesn't make you feel old to hear those stories.
I am old.
No.
I'm coming to terms.
Perennially young.
I'm coming to terms.
You look exactly the same as you did a decade ago.
I don't feel that way. Last night I was moaning because my back is hurting.
It's the cold.
And you didn't have any
heat. It's not your age.
I had no heat.
It's the ice.
Yeah.
Right. It's to the point where kids of people who have competed on American Idol will be competing on American Idol. That's how generational you're awesome. Getting.
Yeah, that's how old I'm getting. That's right.
Thank you once again for making us all feel old.
No. It's very exciting that it's coming back. So we're looking forward to that. And that will be in Los Angeles. So the fun for me is I'll be hosting live with Kelly and Ryan during the week and my radio show from here, mm-hmm. and then flying back on the weekends to do American Idol.
You're a busy man.
Yeah,
coast to coast. We can't wait to
coast
watch.
Coast to coast. There it is.
Can't wait to watch.
It's going to be freezing for New Year's Rockin' Eve.
Good luck.
Please, come on out. Okay, and there you go on that video as well. That is it for my evening news report right here on the Riley King Network. I hope you all have a great rest of your Friday night, and I'll see you back here tomorrow with more news reports. Good night, everyone. Bye.